Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see as good intentions is for clout and haters mad. You can never be a subject, carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm pacing. I got choices, I'm getting opinions from so many folks. To bring the horses so I can get up away from all the noise. Too many people tell me what I should do, I take it and laugh. They not knowing if I mess up, I can end up falling flat. If I write a bad tweet, lagging in my whole street. If I give them what they want, then I'm gonna be broke in a week. If I tell my baby no, she might get it from the street. If I'm not tough for my son, he might grow up to be weak. What do I do? I'm new to having cameras in my face. What do I do to keep getting the love from my state? What do I do to keep the money coming in? What do I do? Writing until I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see as good intentions is for clout and haters mad. You can never be a subject, carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, trapping at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm pacing. Feel like Jesse Owens, cause I'm taking off with the race. Put the medal to his mouth, retain his tongue, hold the brace. But I'm all about the beast until the sucker hit a make. Oh man, eat man, your performance kinda shaky. I'm prepared for the fame, I like that crap, sound really like me. But I'd be lying if I said I didn't cry at least once a week. Cause I'm so blessed with no stress, all the way taking off of me. Head in the clouds and I smile like no grandma watching me. My dream came true, I'm loving all these cameras in my face. I never knew that I would get the love from my state. Stay with the flu, always keep the
Madden Football is the home of Super Bowl 56, and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Bengals and the Rams, and it comes your way next.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Cincinnati Bengals taking on the NFC champions, the Los Angeles Rams. Here come the Bengals, and CD, of course, it's Joe Burrow out of LSU at quarterback.
And he's been sensational all season long, but he saved his best work for the playoffs, leading his guys to the AFC championship a couple of weeks ago. And now he knows what lies ahead. He's going to need to play a near-perfect four quarters of football to get his guys to the finish.
Oh, wide open, complete, and all the way in for a Cincinnati score. T. Higgins with a first touchdown of this Super Bowl, and along with it that. And the Bengals are on the board first here in this Super Bowl. If there was one knock on Joe Burrow coming out of LSU, it was arm strength, but kind of put those doubts to rest right there.
And we knew that this offense was going to try and put pressure on the secondary. That was something they talked about with us. They knew that they had an advantage, pressed it, and there you go. Big play for a touchdown on their very first possession.
And the final number on Next Gen Stats, how about this? 71 yards through the air. This one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. From the end zone, here comes Brandon Powell. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. They'll be led out by their quarterback in his 13th NFL season now. It's Matthew Stafford. Here's the first carry of the game for Cam Akers. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That's exactly what you're looking for at the inside linebacker spot. Versatility. He can drop into coverage, or as he did on that last play, use his speed to get to the perimeter and knock the ball carrier for a loss.
On second and 12, Stafford. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. A shotgun snap for Stafford. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Stafford now to throw. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
From the gun, here's Stafford. And he'll find his target, Woods. It's complete. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons everywhere. They want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And across midfield he goes and into Bengal territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Second and 4. Here's Stafford. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 35.
That was a nice run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target. This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Gonna run the sweep here. This is Cobb. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, and one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Facing a second and 6 from the 8. Off the fake to Akers, here's Stafford. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
Second down incompletion. They'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Stafford going to give to Akers on the draw. Akers hit. He coughs it up. And the Bengals grab it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Pardon me, you know how often we hear about the red zone, right? From the 20-yard line going in, that scoring zone, getting points on the board. A lot of teams call from the 10-yard line in the green zone. That's your money zone. He fumbles the ball inside the money zone. You have one job, take care of the ball. That didn't happen.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
We're going to shoot. After reviewing the
play, we're going to appeal the conversion.
So that challenge, a successful one. So now the Rams send out the field goal team here. This is a 26-yard attempt. Gay's kick is good. And they are on the board, trailing now 6-3. So they get the 3 points, but they've now had 3 trips into the red zone, and that's all they've come away with.
And in the NFL, the way they measure red zone efficiency and success, did you score touchdowns on those drives? That's first and foremost. Getting points, that's the second measurement. So by that measure, they haven't done very well. They've got to figure that out.
After the made field goal, Gay back out there to kick it off. Brandon Wilson to return it. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Drive about to get going. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here.
So many times we see teams go on the road and want to lean on their running game, but this crew just announced they're going to try and air it out and make hay downfield.
Second and 10. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. And the Rams got it. They bring it down. Aaron Donald just so strong they can't block him, and he records the sack.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Oh, he'll let one go deep for Higgins. And the defense loses him. It's complete. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. T. Higgins, his second touchdown in the Super Bowl. Bengals are able to grow their lead. Still first quarter, 2 receiving touchdowns for him. How are they going to slow him down?
I think they're thinking about altering their game plan. Whatever they came in with, now maybe you switch a better cover guy to him. Or you make sure you have more people in his general area, wherever he lines up, to at least try and discourage them from throwing the ball to him.
And Burrow's going to look to throw for it. And he's got it. So the drive for 2 successful. And that bumps their lead up even further. After 1, a 14-3 ball game. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Bengals in control of the football. Here's McPherson now to send it away. Powell now to take it out of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time to have a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
Well, one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Stafford's throw here, hard in by Cup. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Stafford gonna give this to Akers. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Out of the gun, Stafford. A quick pass to Cup. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
That'll be caught. It's Cup. And he's going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
They'll run on first down with Akers. And they'll get him down right around the 16. It was Jordan Evans making the play defensively.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. 2 minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. Now Stafford. And he's got it. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one.
Very important third down conversion right there, because when you're trailing and find yourself this deep in enemy territory, the kicker's not even part of your thought process. You got to make it pay off with six. Nice connection right there to set up first and goal.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this foot. And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown. Cam Akers punching it in from a yard away. And the Rams have got this back to a one-score game. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
Matt Gay on for the extra point. Not no good. He missed it. Missed the PAT. And this will remain a 5-point game. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Wilson now on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Bengals offense returns to the field. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
On first and 10, Joe Burrow. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here's Burrow. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Eluding the pressure right. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, and his first carry of the game right there. He had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well. Burrow now off the bootleg. Buying time to his left. Now he'll turn and throw deep back to the other side of the field. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. That's caught by the tight end, Drew Sample. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Now Burrow on first down. He'll air this one out for Boyd. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He's certainly not been afraid to take some chances downfield. Now, look, it's paid off for him a couple of times. That time, not so fortunate.
And that's where I want to start, what you said. It's paid off a couple of times. So his aggressiveness has been good for his offense for the most part. So he throws an interception there. No one likes that, but I would not rein him back in. The return on investment thus far has been pretty good. Two touchdowns to one interception.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get in the field goal range. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. On first down, it's Stafford. He gets this into the hands of Kupp once again. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Here's Stafford. Over the middle, that's hauled in by Kupp. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. They'll fake it. Now Stafford. And that'll be
be caught by Kopp. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. The final shot before the break, Stanford. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, time for a check of the next-gen stats from that first half for Cincinnati. And it's been the passing game that's gotten them to where they are, two quarters away from a possible Super Bowl title. Meanwhile, for the Rams, they too were able to take advantage of a soft secondary, as both of these two teams really threw the ball at will in that first half. These two teams have had plenty of extra time to make their final adjustments, but time's just about up. The final half of the NFL season is upon us. So let's get it back out to our Super Bowl broadcast team. Here's Brandon and Charles.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. Powell now to take it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Get a look at this offense led by Cooper Kupp as they make their way back onto the field. And as we look at the tape, he's getting close to 200 yards. Think he can smell it?
He can not only smell it, he can probably count it. And he's looking to get there and beyond it. But right now, what we're seeing, a lot of junk defenses like in basketball when you're trying to stop a leading scorer and they just have no answers for him right now. Whatever they're throwing out there, he's going right through it.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they trail here in the Super Bowl, but fortunately for them, Charles, very much still within striking range.
Yeah, things didn't go exactly the way they planned in the first half. To me, they appeared to be a little bit tight, made a few errors that normally wouldn't. But, of course, this is the Super Bowl, so things get a little bit heightened in that regard. But I think they have to feel a little fortunate. They're only down what they are here starting the third quarter. You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Going up top for Kupp, and that is incomplete.
But you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those, but the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
To throw again on second down. Stafford, the Bengal pressure, gets him that time. Down he goes. The Clemson product, DJ Reader, got in for the sack.
A CD, you know, so often we talk about quarterbacks holding on to the ball too long. Well, we can't say that there. He had no time to do much of anything.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Into the secondary, past the 40, and all the way up to the 46.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going, and a points result, we'll call this play significant.
Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. Now Stafford. Trying to find Kupp, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. And the Bengals are going to get it back here just past the 35. The first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Obviously not what they were striving to accomplish, but you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing, they're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
And he goes out right around the 39. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
From the 39, Burrow. And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him. Sebastian Joseph Day forced his way through, drops him for a loss of 10 yards.
But partner, we know they came out of the locker room down on the scoreboard. That will guarantee you the defensive side of the ball gets super emotional. They can come out and play with aggressiveness, with fury, because they don't have to be quite as precise. And it paid off for them on that play, didn't it?
Sure did. Excellent play, really setting the tone for this third quarter. He's got a man complete. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. A big play there for Cincinnati.
And that looked almost to be a case of, you know, a quarterback saying, hey, I'm going to throw this as far as I can and hope you run under it. Mission accomplished.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Open space inside the 10. And he's all the way down to the 6-yard line.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times, defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in.
But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Second and goal from inside the 5. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And he will take it on in for Bengals touchdown.
Joe Mixon
taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Bengals will extend their third quarter lead here in this Super Bowl. Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it's in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
L.A. set to take over again on offense.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They can run out on the first play and attack the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
Quite sure what just happened there, other than we do know that he spiked the football on first down.
Second and 10 here in the third quarter of Super Bowl 56.
They'll fake the give. Now Stafford. And bringing it in right side here, Beckham. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone.
It's taking a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
They'll run on first down. Akers. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. One quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Second and 12.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Rams trailing, but they do have the football as we start the fourth and final quarter. Going for it all.
And, oh, that would get a wide-up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone. Probably should have been. Third down coming up.
The Rams on third down. A perfect 4-for-4 thus far. This is third down and 12. Off of play action. Here's Stafford.
That ball nearly intercepted, but he could not hang on. Oh, a pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, at least, it'll be fourth down.
I think someone's going to get into QB1's ear when he gets to the sideline. Already thrown an interception. That one should have been picked. Look, let's just be honest about it. That'd be the second person in his ear because he's hearing it in the huddle right now.
Not the start to the game he wanted. Like you said, the pick on the opening drive, second drive, not much better. And this will be broken up and incomplete. Now a penalty flag down. And they may be going backward here. So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that could be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on fourth down. Desperation time for Stafford on fourth down. He'll get this one to Cup, complete. But they're going to wrap him up as he'll go down well short of a first. No luck for the Rams as they fail here on fourth down. And the Bengals will get the football back.
Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10
at their own 21.
Meanwhile, Burrow's throw taken in here by Chase.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39.
I like that they're staying aggressive on offense, because to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
And here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. C.J. Uzomah, 61 yards.
And the Bengals are feeling good as they extend their lead in the Super Bowl. I tell you, for a defender, that's got to be a scary sight, seeing a big man like this with a head of steam behind him as he makes that catch and then turns upfield.
Yeah, normally when you talk about tight ends, you immediately begin talking about them rumbling down the field. But to me, he was pretty well gliding downfield there. Very athletic for a big man, and he takes this one all the way to pay dirt.
They'll try and throw for it. And this is going to be intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And the Rams are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line.
Well, as most teams do in their 2-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you get a chance to take it all the way back at 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case there. But that's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Now a play fake it at Stafford. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
On second and 10, Stafford.
Again, he targets Cup, and this time he's got it.
Touchdown! Cooper Cup, 59 yards. And the Rams have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. And nothing too crazy there. A quick slant, and then he just had a seam. He found a seam.
And when you hit it on the run like that, and I mean the pass right to the receiver who's already in motion and moving, sometimes he just takes it and runs away from everyone else.
And he ran it into the end zone, and the defense, they've got to adjust there quickly. That's tough on them.
That's really
tough because everything was executed well. Ball was out of his hands quickly, into the hands of the receiver, and then he was gone.
They'll try and run it here. And he's going to be hit and taken down in the backfield. Just nowhere to run that time. And the try for two is snuffed out. So the defense gets the stop. I know it's situation to situation, but who has more pressure there, offense or defense, when they go for two?
I truly believe it's the defense has more pressure because the offense has an entire playbook wide open from the two-yard line. You can run it. You can throw it. So defensively, I think most teams are going to be aggressive and force the issue and try and bring pressure.
Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal.
They've got his man complete. Touchdown, Bengals. Tanner Boyd, 48 yards. And the Bengals are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
You have fun with this one, partner.
I am. I mean, he's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
Four touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. So now the Bengals offense will stay out there as he'll decide to go for two. They'll let Mixon try and run it in. And he will dive into the end zone, and a two-point conversion is successful. Touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. They're going to take this up close to the 40, so really good starting field position. The offense for Los Angeles returns to the field. Those Super Bowl hopes that they had really dwindling now here in the fourth quarter. That NFC crown that they got 2 weeks ago seems like a distant memory, as they have been outplayed tonight. Stafford on first down. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big play there on the catch and run. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
On first down, Stafford here. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete.
I can put my defensive cap on right now. I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
Again, it's Stafford. Touchdown, Rams! Matthew Stafford finding Cooper Kupp for the touchdown there. And the Rams are able to cut into this lead.
The fourth quarter touchdown there, back to a two-score game, but time is not their ally.
No, it's not, partner. They still have a pulse, but it's probably a little weak right now. A lot of things have to go right in these final 2 minutes plus for them. I think they have to be thinking onside kick here, and we know how difficult those are to recover.
Extra point by Gay is up and good, and they're able to cut this deficit down to 12.
Thank you.
after the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Kicks it on the ground with a squib, taken around the 28. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it out past the 30.
Cincinnati set to take over once again. And they have been the better of the two sides to this point with a two-score lead, fourth quarter of this Super Bowl, and the Lombardi Trophy within reach as they start this drive first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Burrow.
He'll buy some time right.
Oh, he'll let one go deep for Higgins.
And this one is incomplete.
After what they faced during this game where they've given up a ton of yards downfield, it has to be a measure of revenge right there for the secondary. They've been shredded throughout the game and finally forced an incompletion.
Here's second and 10.
Burrow on play action, out to his left. Oh, he'll try and throw it deep to the other side of the field. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off around the 27. And he will take this across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. After the interception, here's Stafford.
He's going to look for Beckham in the end zone.
And that will be caught, but out of the end zone, says the field judge. It's ruled incomplete.
This defense was definitely
And now it appears that the referee's been buzzed, and we'll get a review of this being inside 2 minutes of play. Everything coming from up above. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball positioned?
After review of the play, ruling on the field, game.
So the folks in New York just going to wind up confirming what the official saw as this play will stand as is.
To throw once more on second and 10. Stafford. And Woods has it complete. And he's taken down inside the 30. Well, he flew past 200, 300, 400 yards. Now he's over 450 yards passing on the day.
So what you're saying is oxygen for everyone catching the ball and trying to defend?
Yeah, especially those guys trying to defend right now.
No doubt. They've got to be a confused group because they haven't been able to defend him very well at all. And I think he just wants to keep firing. When you have that kind of a day, you're just locked in. Just keep calling those pass plays.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Passing lanes tough to come by with so many defensive backs on the field here late in the game. And it's not just the number of bodies. It's their quickness and their agility that makes it tough to complete a pass.
Meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as it comes with a minute 4 left to go in the game. Gonna run the sweep here. This is Cobb. And he takes this one into the end zone. And all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably gonna rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
Gay is on for the point after. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And it's caught. He got it in the end zone. So instead of trying to get 1 point closer, they roll the dice on the fake and come up with two. And that's something you almost never see nowadays. When you fake it,
You're at the 15-yard line on a PAT as opposed to just going for it from the two.
I'm sorry. I know they got it, and congratulations to them, but it's just not a good play. I mean, the risk-reward is really off the charts. Not in your favor. Run your offense out there. Put it on the 2-yard line if you want to go for two. But I'll be darned. They ended up getting that one, didn't they?
Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Cincinnati's offense coming back here onto the field. And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. That one looks like he'll throw here. Being chased out left.
He's going to have the hookup here to Chase.
Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Here we go with Burrow on the move to his left. Able to get away. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter play. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Now it's Burrow rolling to his left. And now he'll let this one go deep, back over the middle. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And the Rams are right back in this football game.
Oh my, how the tables have turned now. They were trying to salt this one away, but that interception, potentially a game changer.
And I just got to think to myself, at this point of the game, I know you've been aggressive. I know that's your MO, and that's fine. And all those teams that talk about all gas, no brakes, you better have the emergency lever to pull occasionally. They could have used it right there. They put themselves in a tough spot with that interception.
Now it's Stafford.
And oh, that one nearly intercepted. That would have sealed it. Instead, it'll be second down.
Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Stafford. That'll be caught. It's caught. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds remaining. Going to run the sweep here. This is Cup. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Stafford now to throw. Well, that'll be caught by Kopp. Still fighting. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
One last throw here for Stafford. Touchdown! He's in on the game's final play. No time on the clock, and they're the Super Bowl champions.
Wow. So for those of little faith, guess what? It got done. They now have the lead with that touchdown this late in the contest. I wonder if that was a play they were holding or a play that they just knew would work from past experience.
Well, I just saw it in their eyes on the sideline before starting that last drive, and they did. You're right. They got it done. Looks like they're going to be the winners.
The Rams have won the Super Bowl, and they will get the Lombardi Trophy. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs. You see the guys sharing the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them. A fantastic season.